All right. We're going. Let's get going. Dude, it took me like 20 minutes off screen to finally get that RNG to work. Can you imagine the poor, like, Skyrim week one person that had no guide that just sat there and did Riften, like, Thieves Guild Riften missions?
Well, look at you. If only everyone acted like you did.
Trying to get that, the special ones? That's ludicrous. But thankfully, I think this is the end. I think once I do these, turn these two quests in, and then do the special quest I have now, that'll be it for restoring the Thieves Guild. God, I hope so.
Alfred, you're here, and not a moment too soon. If anything should happen to Arn, there'll be...
I have it up high enough? Okay.
Go to pay.
I guess he just talks quiet.
A close friend of mine. We fought together on the battlefield for many years until old age got the better of us. Now it's up to me to save him one more time. This time, from the executioner's block in Solitude. The city guard in Solitude is seeking Arn for a serious crime. When he fled here, he was arrested for drunken behavior. Can you imagine? Fortunately, his identity isn't known to the authorities in Whiterun, so there's still a chance to save him. Hold a moment. This is more than a simple prison break. I want to have Arn's name stricken from the record books permanently. I'm setting him up with a new identity. It's the only way to throw the guard permanently off his trail. The job is twofold. First, steal a letter that was sent from Solitude warning Whiterun's guard to be on the lookout for Arn. The second is to change Arn's name in the prison registry to his new identity. If it was easy, I would have hired a local thug instead of a professional. You see, both of these items are kept inside Dragon's Reach. And they don't allow visitors inside the Jarl's or the Steward's Chambers.
Yeah, they do.
One more thing. If you get caught, I can't afford to be connected to you. Remember that before you do anything stupid. I have eyes within Dragon's Reach. They tell me that all correspondence from other holds are sent to the Jarl's private chambers. It's a well-known fact that the steward keeps all of the records on Whiterun's prisoners in a large book. My sources tell me You can find that book in a study in his quarters. Change Arn's entry in the book to anything you want, and they'll be forced to let him go after he serves a few weeks. You watch yourself.
This is one of those quests that I think they thought out before they really implemented the game system, but like, you're literally allowed to just walk into his bedroom. Like, the guards don't attack you. So this entire premise doesn't make any sense. It literally says take. It doesn't even say steal. That says steal, though. Dude, I'm so anxious.
We're one of the same kind.
Alfred. Arn? Never heard of him. I guess that means you're finished. Here's your payment. Tell Delvin that he has my support and all the weight it carries in Whiterun from now on. I think he'll be quite pleased. Watch yourself,
Father. Ah, hello. What are you hunting? Never mind. I don't want to know.
My skin tars. Do I have the materials to upgrade my Schmittars? Oh boy. I don't think they'll be very good even with all the smithing perks or smithing gear I have. That's a little unfortunate. I'm going to invest into alchemy at some point so that I can like naturally make good potions to enhance like smithing and enchanting, but I'm not going to do the restoration loop because that literally invalidates any run.
Yes?
It's not like getting your numbers high just means that you can kind of like have an easier time on the harder difficulties, but like restoration loop literally makes legendary like a nothing. It's ridiculous.
Shall be troubling you. Yeah? I'll listen. Alfred sent ahead his compliments. Looks like his friend Arn is soon to be released, thanks to his brand new identity. More importantly, he's pledged the full support of the Battleborn clan to the Thieves Guild. We're still growing by leaps and bounds, thanks to you. And other merchants moved into the space outside the flagon. You're a natural. Never seen anything like it. We got a long way to go, but don't let that bother you. It's our father that we've been in years. This kind of work suits you, but it's going to end up making you rich. I want you to head out to Markov and speak to Endon. He's a silversmith. He has some kind of shop there. His father was a good friend of the guild back in the day, and we could really use his family's influence back on our side. If you're ever looking for some extra coin.
Well, you done or what? Oh, you're back? I suppose you'll be wanting your pay then.
Got word from Torsten Krulsey. In Windell. That a rival guild is trying to get itself started. Not only that, but they're giving us thieves a bad name by murdering their marks. Get over there and see what you can do.
Yeah, boy! Thieves Guild restored, baby. Let's do Silver Lining first. Do I have a companion? I don't. Maybe they just don't follow you down here. Oh, wait. Hold on. That might be why this is running so poorly. Yeah, I also had I had Edge open. That would explain some of that being extra bad. Oh, I don't have a follower. No! How much weight am I at? There's a I want a follower. Pine Watch is a really long dungeon. How do I keep losing my followers? Oh, I didn't. Okay.
Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink. Oh, it's you. Sorry to hear.
I work
I'm what you'd call a soldier of fortune.
My wife Kira runs with me and
offer. Oh, thank goodness.
And I just
I'm
might
not sure where else to turn.
Watch your back, friend.
Several months ago, I ordered a special silver mold from some artisans in Valenwood by way of a Khajiit caravan. Well, it never arrived. Later, I found out that it was robbed by a group of bandits led by someone named Regal Strongarm. Look, I talked to the Jarl, the steward, the housecarl, everyone. They all told me their resources were spread too thin right now. Word on the street says that the Thieves Guild is coming back into its own in Markarth. So I figured... Exactly. Look, this mold is irreplaceable. I'll pay you well for its return, and I can also prove to be quite a valuable ally to the Thieves Guild. Yes, indeed. The only thing I can tell you is that the mold was taken to the bandits' hideout, a small cottage called Pine Watch. I'm not sure how many men they have inside, but I trust that won't be an issue for you. Good luck. I ask my daughter Adara.
Would it be faster to go from stones? Probably the stones. There'll be less enemies too, so it'll go quicker. I think that's the longest load I've had this entire run. My computer might sound like a lawnmower. No, it is lawn. Yeah, lawnmower. But it runs Skyrim. No, I'll have to go around. Yeah, it would be faster to go from the Shrewcone basement.
there, friend. The best tales are those of adventure. Who could truly...
There it is. What's your name?
What's a milk drinker like you doing out here? Go home to your mother. Why? What are you gonna do? Cry? I don't have to take that from you.
Dude, you gotta get off her if you want me to hit her. Dude, are you really gonna do this to me?
Don't set anything on fire, all right? Endon's mold. I'm afraid you have the wrong place, my friend. You'll find no silversmiths here. I assure you, I have nothing of value. I'm nothing but a poor woodcutter just trying to make ends meet. Well, Endon is a silversmith in Markarth, so I just assumed. So that's how it's going to be, huh? Fine. Take your best shot.
Never should have come.
Man, candlelight seems to make the string choke pretty bad. So Sorry. I try not to use it. But some areas in the game are just dark. That's why it's a spell in the game. Come on, man. Oh, I guess this way's a dead end. But I need to change that back before I forget. I've been in this dungeon a bunch of times and I never even knew there was a little death pit there. Oh, the other way was the right way. I'm just stupid. Okay. Thank you. Oh shit. She's got body hair like a mammoth. This place is way shorter than I remember. I just must be bad at this most of the time. I forgot there was this Stone of Baron's Eye here too. Oh, I'm not redoing this entire level because of that. Oh man. Oh, dude, it might be worth it. I don't want to do Red Eagle again. I'm not redoing Red Eagle. I hate that. Thank you. I did miss that, though.
Time to end this little game.
So maybe it was good that I accidentally read that. It was like fate speaking to me. Hang on, I gotta take a text. Alright, sorry about that. I don't know who's watching, but... Where am I? Oh, that's right, I came in through that way. That's one of the other problems with the engine limitations, is they describe her as, like, some hairy, ugly oaf. But she's, like, a beautiful Nordic woman. She's got, like, no body hair whatsoever. It's really weird. This is like some unintentional comedy stuff.
Feeling I just woke from a nap.
Wait, I'm the one that needs healing. Me when I drink that Sprite Cranberry at 3 a.m.
you being pardoned. I got some wonderful jewelry.
My fa-
Are you- What can an old scar-
Work silver, like my father.
My wife Kira runs our jewelry. You've more than proven that the Thieves Guild is back on its feet in our city, and earned every bit of your reward. Tell Delvin that he can count on me to provide the influence around here with the right people when he needs it. If you're ever looking to sell any illegally obtained merchandise, I'd also provide my services as a fence. It's the least I can do. Trinkets, odds and ends, that sort of thing. When you get back to Riften. I promise you, I buy much more than simple silver trinkets.
Frost Farm. My daughter Fiope. She was murdered a few months ago. Left her laying on the ground in a pool of her own blood. I assumed they were after her valuables. She always wore far too much jewelry in public. And I told her it'd be the death of her. I never thought. No need to explain. I'm well aware of your guild's methods. It took me weeks, but I finally tracked down the killer. A bloody Altmer at that. Can you imagine? Let's just say I'm a firm believer in eye for an eye and leave it at that. He fancied himself a thief in some sort of new guild forming around here. Gave me some valuable information before. Well, like I told Del, I think we can help each other. You recover what I'm looking for and take out a rival guild in the process. Exactly. One of the pieces stolen from her was a silver locket. A cruel sea family heirloom. I want it back. The only name I have is Norn. There's a house right here in Lunhill. That's where you should begin looking.
Should have been an adventure.
Yes, can I help you with something? Fiodli. Where have I heard that name? Oh, of course the poor girl who was murdered. Such a beautiful young thing. A tragedy, to be certain. How dare you? You're accusing me of taking part in such a heinous act? I should have you arrested for even suggesting such a thing. Now, just a moment. Let's think about this, you know, discuss it like two rational people. Look, I had no choice. They're crazy. I could be killed. It's a guild of Altmer thieves. They call themselves the Somerset Shadows. Their leader, Linway, he's the worst of the lot. He steals valuables from the dead.
No, Linway prefers stealing from the deceased. Digs up the corpses, breaks into the hall of the dead. He even stole that locket right off that poor murdered girl's body. Or what was left of it.
I used to fence for the Thieves Guild in Skyrim a long time ago.
When Linwe moved into the area, he contacted me and said if I didn't fence for them, he'd kill me. If I tell you, you need to promise not to kill me. I'd prove to be quite an asset to the Thieves Guild, and one of the best fences in Skyrim. Linwe is holed up in a place called Uttering Hills Cave. He's got his entire guild there, so be careful. After you're done with all this, come back anytime, and I'll make good on my end of the bargain. Some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasures.
Yeah, these guys don't level. These guys are fixed levels, so they're just getting... Oh no. These guys are about to get annihilated. Oh, he actually does. He is a little strong, okay. I love how his gear looks. I'm pretty sure I'm on Master, if not Legendary. This is ridiculous, bruh. I need to enchant him a super cool sword and some gear. If I'm gonna be carrying him around. Maybe I'll do that off screen.
So good. Oh, thank you.
My own Hollyfrost, it pains me to see this locket. To be reminded of Fjolni once more, but I'm glad it's back where it belongs. Tell Delvin that if he still desires to have my support for the Thieves Guild in Windhelm, he's got it.
Should have been an adventurer like you.
Look at this place. Who's this dude? Oh, this rune.
Hey. So you're the one everyone's falling over. Morrowind, of course. Any Dunmer worth their weight in ash would tell you the same. I used to be a member of the Morang Tom. We were an assassin's guild that was sanctioned by the Empire to provide public, as well as private, executions. We did this in the name of Mephala, whom I used to quite fervently worship. No, in fact, the Tom were quite the bitter rivals with the Dark Brotherhood. Where they operate within the shadows, we operated on the side of justice. I didn't have a choice. When the Red Mountain erupted in Morrowind, the Tom fled, spread to the Nine Winds. We made a pact that one day we might reunite. And I believe that day is long in coming. Have you taken leave of your senses? If the Dark Brotherhood discovered I had been a Morang Tom, they would have come after me with a vengeance. Better to stay out of sight and ply me trade with the Thieves Guild than risk a contract on me head. I should hope so. The Dark Brotherhood is also known to place contracts on those who associate with the Morang Tom as well. So, unless you wish a visit from one of their own, I'd suggest you follow your own advice and keep your mouth shut. Finally, now I can get back to you.
Still running.
All that work just to get some asshole in here.
Got lots of junk available. Need some gold. I may have some work for you. I hear Endon's quite pleased to have his merchandise back. He's a powerful ally in Markarth. Should help the guild regain a foothold in the west. The guild's at full strength, and we have you to thank for it. We've had our share of dark times. Now they seem like a distant memory. I'm gonna tell you something you'll never hear me say again. But if you tell anyone I told you, I'll deny it. When you walk through the guild, don't be ashamed to hold your head high, because you're the best damn thief in the place. Tolston was gratified the death of his daughter was avenged and the heirloom was returned. At this very moment, he's laying the groundwork for the guild to re-establish itself in Windhelm. I wish you could have sent more of a message to those Somerset Shadows upstarts, but hopefully they'll stay out of our business. The guild's at full strength, and we have you to thank for it. I'm gonna tell you, when you walk through the guild...
Oh, did I forget to do something? It doesn't say anything in there, so I don't care.
Before we get down to business, I've got something I need you to do. Well, as you know, the guild's growing and things are looking up around here. The only thing we're lacking is a reliable way to transport our merchandise across Skyrim. I'm not sure if you've noticed, but there are several Khajiit caravans that travel across the realm. They're shrewd traders and don't mind getting their hands dirty. I bartered with their leader, Rasad, on more than one occasion. Actually, I want you to bring him something. You see, the caravans are notorious for transporting illegal substances. Present Rasad with this satchel of moon sugar, and I bet my last septum he'll make a deal. Rasad is the head of a small syndicate of independent merchant families. Each caravan is obliged to pay dues, but in return, a small portion of the profits are shared between them, and the leader parcels out the routes. If we could make contact with them, they could provide an excellent way to inconspicuously transport goods for us. It's an illegal substance highly favored by the Khajiit, very difficult to come by. If moon sugar is refined properly, it can be used to make skooma, another substance that will knock you over after a single draft. I've got coin and I've got merchandise. Let's see what we can do.
Yeah, boy. 4,000 gold.
You'll find.
You approach as if you know us, stranger. Who are you, and what do you want? Yes, I've heard the guild is rising back to power. An alliance would be most beneficial to both parties. I will consider the offer, but I'll have to discuss it with the other caravans. Ah, moon sugar. I could smell it on you. I am pleased with this offer, and accept. Take my word to the leaders of your guild and tell them we look forward to a prosperous and profitable future. If you happen upon any of our caravans in your travels, we'd also be more than willing to pay you a fair sum for any of your stolen goods. Take a look.
Now, I've never actually done all of this before.
Give my regards to them.
What enemies are nearby?
How?
Okay, whatever. I've never done this before, before doing the main stuff. Because I hate doing it, so I always put it off. I wonder what Mercer Frey says if you get everything done.
You need?
Well, glad to know he reacts to it.
So, welcome to the cozy little family. Yeah, good. I'll contact some of my people and have them prepare some shipments right away. Good job. Here. Let me give you something for all the legwork. Trinkets, odds and ends, that sort of thing.
It's kind of the same voice, but she's doing like a different tone. That was a weird take. Have I trained this level? I probably need to go and check that. It's fucking disgusting, by the way. It's a sewer. Well, I brought the Thieves Guild to prosperity and broke the curse that Mercer Frey started. I wonder if the game will acknowledge that.
Don't you have better things to do than disturb me? A word of advice. Don't disappoint me.
Yeah. Okay, so we're gonna go do the Mine of Madness.
I've been a bit out of sorts.
Lord Nilsine has been wrecked. I hope RK grants my wife some comfort. Thank you. Change swept into the swamp. Need something? That I am. We train the recruits. Turn boys into men. That sort of thing. Thinking of asking the general for some training books. Give the soldiers something to do while they're at rest. Something besides drinking. Ever seen a book called The Mirror? We used to hand it out to boys looking to learn basic shield work. Good on you. Good. I'll see if I can get some copies made for the men. Here, something for your trouble. The Legion thanks you. Keep my men.
You stay out of trouble now. Castle Dower
Dungeon. Why didn't I just fast travel over? That was stupid of me.
The Imperials are good.
I have so many things to do, so many undesirables to contend with. Naysayers, buffoons, detractors. My headsman hasn't slept in 3 days.
You are far too hard on yourself, my dear, sweet, homicidally insane Pelagius. What would the people do without you? Dance, sing, smile, rolled. You are the best septim that's ever ruled. Well, except for that Martin fellow. But he turned into a dragon god. And that's hardly sport. You know, I was there for that whole sordid affair. Marvelous time. butterflies, blood, a fox, a severed head, and the cheese to die for.
Yes, yes, as you've said countless times before.
Harumph! Well, then, if you're going to be like that, perhaps it's best I take my leave. A good day. How rude! Come free! Ooh! Well, actually, but seriously, what's the message? Wait! Was it wrong? Ha! No, but more. Because that's crazy! You do... I mean, really. Now that's... So, you have to find the way out first. Care to take a look around? This is... Welcome. Now, the Wabatak! You've headed down the path of dreams. Unfortunately for you, Pelagius suffered night terrors from a young age. All you need to do is find something to wake our poor Pelagius up. You'll find his terrors easy to repel, but persistent. To crow about. With Pelagius up and about, you're moving right along. We'll both be home in no time.
Sorry, but like, I've seen too many videos where people put in his lines, and I'm so tired of Shia Gorth humor.
Ah! Now this is a sad path. Pelagius hated and feared many things. Assassins, wild dogs, undead, pumpernickel.
Never should have come here.
Keen as needed. For his spouse. The attack he makes on himself can be seen here fully. They're always carried out. He gets one of his friends. The self enhances Pelagius' anger. But his confidence will shrink with every hit. You must bring the two into balance. Wonderfully done. Pelagius is finally ready to love himself and continue hating everyone else. Oh, good choice! Well, good for me. I find everyone being out to get you so terribly entertaining. You might find it less so. You see, Pelagius' mother was, well, let us say, unique. Although I suppose, in the grand scheme of things, she was fairly average for a septim. That woman wielded fear like a cleaver. Or did she use the cleaver to make people afraid? Forget that word. Oh, but she taught her son well. Pelagius learned from a very early age that danger could come from anywhere, at any time, delivered. Oh, I thought you'd never figure it out. With the threat gone, Pelagius is under the illusion that he's safe, which means you've helped him out, sir. And we're that much closer to home. Do you mind? So, I've been known to change my mind. So, go. Pelagius Septim the Third. Once the mad emperor of Tamriel. Oh, so boringly sane. I always knew he had it in him. Well, I suppose it's back to the Shivering Isles. A trouble task I can get into. Well, I'm gone simply. Boggles the mind. Let's make sure I'm not forgetting anything. Clothes? Check. Beard? Check. Luggage? Luggage? Where did I leave my luggage? Busy. You have a very delicate
state.
insinuating it, Shepard. As for you, a little fortune to me. Feel free to keep the Wabba Jack. As a symbol of my...
Let's do lights out. Did you know that there's actually a lighthouse keeper? I don't know if it was intentional or not, but it's he never leaves the house.
Supposed to be in here.
Yeah, he never leaves the house. Get a skill book? Someone leveled stuff. But he never leaves the house. I don't know if it's bugged or if it's not supposed to. I always thought that would have been like a stealth element to this part of the quest, right? Is that he like leaves and checks the flame. Or do you have to like fight through him? Maybe he puts a bounty on you, something like that. But nope, you just run out here and tap. You ready for this? Okay. Not bad. I guess it's quick saving and quick loading that let you ignore fall damage. I'm getting hungry. I can't wait. I'm gonna make shrimp scampi.
Looks like you had no trouble. The effects have already been felt. The Ice Runner has failed to dock on time. Without the lighthouse, the Ice Runner would have swung wide of the western shoal and run aground on the eastern coast. My sister Deja will be at the wreck with our Black Blood Marauders. She knows to expect you.
We Where are they? There's always something trying to get at my farm. Not my farm. Well, I guess it is a farm. Oh, that's right. Don't you need to put fish in your own little hatchery? Or does it auto-spawn fish? Oh, I don't have any fish. Oh, did they spawn inside the house? Nope, it's too late. They're stuck in there now. There's one corner of the, I think, that they can attack from.
You're the one who put out the fire in the lighthouse, right? That was good work. Deja's in the hold of the ship. Go down two levels.
My brother told me you were coming. I'm supposed to give you what you've earned. Ha! I'm afraid the loot's already been moved. You've been useful to the Black Bloods, though. You've earned a quick death. Come here.
Get the best of me.
All right, well, I've got to go, but this one's been fun. Bye.